Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Souling the Arc. I'm Flinger Foo, and today we're actually getting ready to go see if we can take down a Titan. Or, well, not really take it down, make it our buddy. Yeah, so that's kind of the plan. And I do believe we may have all the stuff I'm kind of dropping off. I did transfer that, not throw it out. Yeah. All right, making sure we've got all the stuff that we need. Thinking 140 elements should be good. I'm not sure. Honestly. Yeah. It's been a minute since I did these guys. If I remember right, about 50 was good. Because you fly through the stuff. Hey, Foo, you're going to wait here. All right, buddy. But yeah, I think what we're going to do is go see if we can take out the Ice Titan. That way there we can use him for, you know, shenanigans throughout the map. And also help out with, you know, the King Titan and stuff. So, yeah, that's what's on the docket for today. I've already got, let's see. Foozilla, as in, you know, like the Mecha Foozilla. Yes. All right. But yeah, we've got this right here loaded up. I do have a Mastercraft one up there, but honestly, I'm going with this one. It's less damage. I mean, it's a decent one, but also as far as I know, the damage doesn't really determine how much damage the cannon shell does, I think. So I'm going with that bit of maybe knowledge. Hopefully it works. Hopefully, hopefully that's the case. And I'm not gimping myself because I've got a 240 Mastercraft up inside of the tech replicator just sitting there. And that's a lot of DPS on one of these suckers. So, I mean, I guess I could go down and take it out, but these cannon shells are expensive. So, yeah. I think we're going to be going with this, and then every time you take this dude and you put him into a cryopod or you take that thing off him, it damages it. So the amount of times we put him away, double check it, make sure it went with him. But yeah, the amount of times that you put him away determines how much damage is actually done to that thing. So, yeah, I mean, it does, I believe it's 20% or 25% damage, structural damage, to that thing every time you cryo him. And so if I have a Mastercraft one on there, that's going to add up wicked fast. So I'm kind of thinking that I don't want a Mastercraft one on him. All right, let's get... Which direction are we going? We're going this way. Over towards the ice cave. Now, I've got all the stuff on me for the ice cave. I just need to get the artifact, which actually comes from the ice cave. So it should be fine, right? I mean, we'll go with that. Should be fine. I swear, there's no clenchage going on right now, all right? I mean, I may be in full clench mode, but I'm going to tell you guys that I'm not. Okay? I'm just saying, all right? That way there, nobody's going to know just how clenched I am. Yeah? Because it's always, a challenge to do this guy. I mean, it's not like one of those things, it's like, you know, you go out, you just tame a Parasaur kind of thing. You know, you go out and you tame a Mesopithecus, you tame a Foo, you know? You go out and, you know, you go mine some metal. You don't just go out and tame a Titan. I'm just saying, that's not a thing that happens. Alright, there's that. Alright, we need to make sure that... Really? Yep, thanks for the poop. Alright, so... Let's get our butt through this cave. And, I mean, honestly, it should be fine. And that is a really cool looking poop cow. That is a really horrible poop cow. All right, now, I could probably carry some more of these if I wanted to, cannon shells. I could actually go back and go get some more. I mean, I've got, I think, 12 more made. And Grape Ape would be able to carry them, and now would be the time. You know what? Maybe I should do that. Just head back, go grab them, drop these off inside of... Oh, whoa, look at you! Never mind. All right, but yeah, go inside of... go put the cannon shells inside of Grape Ape. See, can we get you back up on top of here? I may just have to cryo you and throw you back out. Oh, the Christmas vent is really hitting these dinos hard. Alright, but yeah, I think I'm going to do that. Cryo them, put them up there, and then we're going to go get the rest of the cannon shells. Alright, and then we get in here. Oh, hello. Dude, I thought you were dead. Alright, but yeah, and then we get in here, then we start clearing everything, and I have to be very, very careful about what all I loot. And I'm going to try to skip as much of this stuff as I possibly can, which means... But... All of these, all the Bigfoots, and all of the Dire Bears are going to aggro on me as soon as they see me. The wolves, not so much, but the wolves are pretty dang cool. I mean, look at them. Well, actually, all the... Dinos in here are pretty cool. And then also, I have to be very, very careful while I'm doing it this way. Because I'm not taking down any Perlovia, which means that they are going to be aggroing on me as Quickspoke. Come on, bears! Come on! As soon as I pop off this saddle, those Perlovias are going to have their way with me. So. And the stuff in this cave is not wimpy by any means. And we can't carry hardly anything. So. There we go. I mean, those cannon shells, they weigh 15 each. And I made up a whole bunch thinking that there were 10. The weight on them was 10, but the weight on them is 15. So, yeah. Well, I went back and got the extras. But we should be good for now. Come on, bears. Thank you. All right, well, I will see you guys over at the other end. Hopefully. Most likely, but still. That Bigfoot up there not gonna aggro? Okay. All right, if you don't want a piece of me, then you don't want a piece of me. Okay. All right, see you guys in a minute. Alright, just picking up the artifact. Waiting on a bear that was apparently out for a swim to come get me. This is fun. What are you doing out there anyway? Oh, well, maybe I don't want to know. There is a Bigfoot over there in the water as well. So apparently they're like skinny dipping or something. I'm not sure. You know, I ain't judging. I mean... Sounds like a lot of fun. Water's a bit cold for that, but, you know, who am I to judge? Okay, let's see. Dump that. Alright, dump a bunch of this onto you just so I can actually move freer. Okay. No Perlovia, please? Any Perlovia? No? Alright, let's do this. Alright, now we are ready to go get our stuff. Or to go shoot things at another thing until it becomes our buddy. Alright. Alright, here we are. Whew, okay, now here's where full clenchage mode actually starts kicking in. Alright, so... What? Oh, it's because I... Really? Yeah. Okay. So I took all of it back. Apparently I can't walk. That's a thing. All right, so there we go. Now that we got that out of the way, put you out. But yeah, see what I was saying? Oh, it didn't damage it. Oh, they must have fixed it. It's just whenever you take it off now. Okay, good. All right, so we've got that. Take all of this. Put 100 of that in you. That's so many cannon shells. If you die, I'm going to be butt out of a lot of cannon shells. Or, yeah, I'm going to be minus a bunch of cannon shells. All right, but they've also got a ton of weight, which means that that's not going to be too big of a deal. All right, so let's put you in our pocket. Because you're just going to end up killing the Titan. Or trying to, at least. Take you, get you off the terminal. All right. Full clenchage mode. Engaged. All right, let's see. That. All right, let's do this. Oh, man. All right. And it's been a minute since I piloted a mech. I mean, I've messed around with it quite a bit, you know, in the off time. But, yeah. It's been a minute since I actually went up against a Titan with a mech, so. All right, let's go. And what we're going to be doing is trying to destroy the corruption on this thing. And while he's... No. While he's aggroed on the other local wildlife, that's what we want. You keep turning at me, man. Good shot. There we go. That's that corruption done and over with. That was quick. And he keeps bugging out. Well, it's not really bugging out. He's just out of render range. What is... What's he doing? There we go. Oh, he was stuck on something. Is that what was going on? And now we need the one on his back right shoulder. Okay, yeah, he is weird now. Look at him. Okay, there we go. Now he's back in the action. No. Okay, that was a bad shot. But two cannon shots is enough to take out his thing. Okay, that was bad. Oh, sorry, tree. Bye. That should hit. Yes. That wasn't the corruption. Okay, that just hit him. Okay, never mind. All right, right now he's just kind of normally he's it's gone. Okay, we got it. Normally he's just in our face. Yeah, that was a bad shot. Okay, so he's a bit buggy. I'm not sure what's going on with that. Honestly, I feel a little bad shooting things at him while he's so bugged out. So he's killing fish. Is he out already? Oh my gosh! Okay, this was the easiest Ice Titan tame I think I've ever had. And there we go! Holy crap! Alright, so... Okay, so I finally was able to kill those saber-toothed salmon that you weren't able to. Okay! This is weird. This guy is wonky. What happened to him? His foot's all wonky and everything. Alright, let me put away the mech here really quick. And then we'll see if we can get Bob over. I'm not sure what's going on. This is weird. We may have to re-log and such. Oh, hey, bud. How you doing? All right, and you know what? I'm going to re-log really quick, and I'll be right back. Also, I do have Raid Dino Feeding on, so that's a thing. All right. All right, and we're back. I just re-logged. Let's see. Okay, now he's a bit... Okay, now he's better. Much better. All right. All right, let's see. So... All right, let's go through the thing. Left-click attack. Smack. Right-click attack. Launch way up above him and then go like that. Okay. Oh, what is... Okay, now I realize that's supposed to be some sort of ice ball, but the way that was pulsing and stuff, that's a phlegm ball, dude. That's a frozen phlegm ball. I mean, look at this. Look at how that is pulsing and gyrating and doing all sorts. That is a 100% flimball. That came from your throat. All right. That, eat that, or, you know, maybe that's a hairball. I mean, you are covered in a lot of hair. That could be a thing. All right. Now, the sea attack freezes everything in front of you or adds to its frozen bit and then makes it... When it raises up, it makes it extra, extra cold. All right, and then also, you can jump, and you ground pound everything. All right, so we're gonna need, since we have raid dino feeding, and raid dino feeding is just a toggle on the single player settings. You can also do it on a server as well. All right, let's see. We need some meat along the way. Apparently, we're not... Oh, that's right. I'm in K mode. Okay, we are hitting things. Okay. Come here. All right, now another one to harvest them. It's not gonna harvest anything, are you? I'm gonna have to go out with a Giga to get you food, huh? Sheesh. All right, but he is healing up slowly. Yeah. All right, so 350,000 hit points, 50,000 weight, 125% melee damage. That's not bad. All right, let's go see just how long it takes us to get this guy back. All right, now that we're no longer in K mode and I'm not noobing it up, I can actually see my jump reticule. All right, let's see. Come on. Little disappointed this guy won't harvest any meat. Not gonna lie. And I realize that they don't make it easy for you to feed him, even with the dino stuff turned on. And without it turned on, you just can't feed him. I mean, look at that damage.
Yeah.
All right. Suck it, Deodons. All right. Let's see if we can get our butt up this way. All right, we got to do this here really quick. There, we got some screenshots. All right, let's get over this way. Now, when it comes around to him being wonky, I'm not sure if that was... I mean, I know that wasn't what was intended, which makes me feel bad with taming him. But you know what? If the game is... If the game's doing that stuff, I mean... I don't know, because he was seriously just... aggroing on everything around him, not me. He was aggroed on me a couple times, but he got stuck whenever he was aggroed on me. That was weird. And there's no way I'm gonna relog after I summon this guy while I'm out on the frozen tundra just so where he'll act right. I'm sorry, that is just, that's like insta death. And what was that yellow thing? Oh, it was a dire bear. Yeah, so, yeah. All right, but we're definitely going to have to run the gig out here so we can feed the biggest bob. Okay, so just walking over things does 300 damage. Sorry. Coming through. Don't mind me. It's fine. I mean, if you want to come aggro on me because I walked over you, that's your prerogative. It's not gonna end well for you. I'm just saying. I mean, ask those guys, right? Now, I don't think I can actually get this guy up to the base. Oh, hey, we could probably deposit them over there, though. Oh, hey, there's the base. Hi, guys. Hey, I brought home a friend. Okay, this will be Bob's perch. All right, Bob, you got this? Is like an amazing perch for you. And if you survive the King Titan fight, I will probably build something on the back of you just to see just how wonky it is, right? But we now have a massive Bob. Far easier to tame than... Yeah. You know, I made Link a video of me, of him actually acting right, and me, because normally, I mean, there was a lot of dinos out there, and that's what he was aggroing on. Honestly, I don't think it was a bug. I think it was just a thing with his AI. Now that I think about it, he was just aggroed on everything, and me included, but when he was aggroed on me, he was not moving properly. Oh, no, Bob! Bob, no! Get back on your... And see, there you are. Now you fell. Congratulations. It's going to take us forever to get you back up. At least you held on. Oh, dude. Broke my rock, man. Now, let's see. Okay, it's not going to take us too long to get you back up here. All right. It was just a hop, skip, and a jump. I have to remind myself to turn you off autofollow. There we go. All right, let's get over here and let's go see just how you look on your... Oh, dang. Bob is looking great. Dude, no. Stop. I thought I whistled you to stop following me again. All right, but hey, as I get him situated, I will... I'm going to end the video for now. And honestly, it took us far less to tame him than I thought it would. So we've got enough for the woody bob down below. So that should be fun. All right, you're not on follow anymore, are you, Bob? All right. Okay. So I will see you guys in the next video. And hey, if you haven't already, make sure you click that like button. I really appreciate it. If you're new around here, subscribe. And until next time, this is Flinger Foo. And take it easy, everybody. It's far easier than I remember. Oh, man. So much easier. Ah, dang. Too easy, actually. Too easy, if you ask me.